each of the setups restricted to one degree of freedom exhibited just one type of motion, the normal mode. But there's another system that you've met in the course that has one degree of freedom and that also moves with simple harmonic motion. Regular as clockwork, a pendulum. We examined its motion in Unit 16. This one is part of a display at the Old Royal Observatory in Greenwich.
This model shows the problems of taking a pendulum clock to sea. Whilst a pendulum's mounting is securely fixed, it's an excellent timekeeper. But as soon as that mounting starts to move, the pendulum's timekeeping goes completely to pieces. And of course, it's quite useless as a timekeeper.
The problem comes from the motion of the pivot point, giving the system 2 degrees of freedom. In fact, if the pivot point is made to move sinusoidally, there are ways of returning to the simplicity of a normal mode system, even with 2 degrees of freedom. This is a double pendulum, where the second bob can swing back and forth on the first bob. The behaviour of the double pendulum will depend on the initial starting positions. For instance, just displace the top bob, leaving the lower one at equilibrium, and release. You can see if there's any common behaviour between the two pendulum bobs by lining up the start positions. In this case, it's clear that the motion was not a normal mode. Each bob maintained a different frequency. However, if you arrange the initial conditions in this fashion, with both bobs displaced by a certain amount, and release, you do get a normal mode. Lining up the traces as before, you can see that, despite the different amplitudes of swing, each pendulum bob oscillates sinusoidally with the same frequency. Here's a second way of starting off, in which both bobs have been displaced from equilibrium by the same amount as before, but this time the lower displacement is in the opposite direction. Once again, you can tell if this is a normal mode, if the oscillations are both sinusoidal and the frequency of each bob is the same. Which it is. In fact, the normal modes you just saw involved initially displacing the bottom pendulum horizontally by root 2 times the displacement of the top pendulum, first to the right and secondly to the left. It's not obvious how you find these starting positions, but the analysis in the text will address this question. Not surprisingly, double pendulums, which could perhaps keep time just so long as the sea waves were sinusoidal, weren't the answer to keeping time at sea. In fact, an 18th century mechanical engineer invented an interesting arrangement of springs and weights to do that job.
In 1730, when John Harrison was making his first marine timekeeper, the only really accurate clocks were pendulum-controlled, because pendulums use gravity as a restoring force. But Harrison wanted a portable precision timekeeper, and so in his first machine, he designed, instead of pendulums, these two bar balancers, which are interconnected at their centre. And as a restoring force, he applied two pairs of helical balance springs, the upper pair, which can be seen here. When Harrison was first bringing this clock to time, he would have adjusted the initial setup of these balance springs until it was close to timekeeping, and then for fine adjustment, he would have used these sliding weights to bring it to true time.
Clearly, this is a more complicated arrangement of springs and particles, working in unison to reduce the degrees of freedom introduced by a rocking ship. But normal modes are not limited to systems connecting pairs of masses. You can get normal modes for systems with any number of particles.